Hi guys, so today I'm actually going to be doing some writing related content. This is a little video about how to professionally format your short story for submission. So you've finished writing your short story, you've edited it, you want to enter it into a competition. How do you make it look professional? How do you make it look as though you know what you're doing? So I'm going to be walking you through this on a short story that I have. And really don't panic about the way that it looks until you get to the end. The most important thing about your story is that it gets written. Now, the tips that I'm going to give you are pretty much universally accepted, but the number one important point about formatting your story for submission is always, always check the submission site on the competition or the publisher's website that you want to submit to. Because every now and again, the publisher will have something slightly different in mind, and you should always go with what they say. So Almond Press has got a really great list of writing competitions. Okay, so if we take a look at the Queen Mary Wassafiri New Writing Prize, and we click on through to their website, then we find lots of useful information, including the deadline, the entry fee, the word count, and it's really important to stick to that because writing prizes tend to have a lot of entrants, so you don't want to give them any reason at all to disregard yours. And then a little bit further down, we find what they're looking for in the formatting. So work must be typed in a legible font, font size 12, double spaced, and submitted as a document. So always, always, always go with whatever the style guide is that the person you're submitting to gives you. But if they don't give you a style guide or they haven't covered everything, such as line spacing, then it's a good idea to carry on with the tips I'm about to give you. Now, most competitions don't want you to put your name and contact information in your story. Most competitions are judged blind to avoid any form of bias. If you're submitting your manuscript to a publisher, though, then they often do want your name and your contact details on the cover page. But today we're just focusing on competition entries. So the safest route to go is black text on a white background, size 12 font, something really legible like Times New Roman, and double line spacing. Don't go with anything swirly, don't go with any funny colours. Just black ink, white paper, size 12 TNR, and double spaced. So the best way to do that in Word is Control plus A for select all. And then you can just go up to change the font size, the font type. And you're just coming down to this little menu here to select double line spacing. Now, if you're not used to laying out your manuscript like this, it might look like it's a little bit too much. You know, it might look like those are some really big gaps between the lines. But the reason that we do that is because sometimes judges want to print things off, and they need a little bit of space between the lines to make notes. Anything between 1.5 and 2 point line spacing is generally fine. Usually we go for 2 because that does give a little bit more space for those notes. Again, just check with the submissions page to see whether or not they have a preference. Now, if you're a neat freak like me, or you've done a lot of academic writing in the past, then your instinct is going to be to fully justify this so that the right and the left side of the page have a straight margin. But I have it on very good authority from my publishing friend that generally speaking, it's a better idea to left justify. So we also call this ragged right. So it's straight down the left, but raggedy on the right. And the reason for this is it's actually easier to read, because the spacing between words is more uniform. Now, if you've written a work of fiction, you also want to first line indent. And no matter how tempting it is to do this, use the indentation function, not the tab button. Using the tab button seems easy, but it's not a stable command. So what that means is that if you upload it to Kobo or say Kindle or different e-readers, then it might not always hold that formatting, and your words or your sentences might migrate across the page or end up being flat against the left. So we always use the line indent function to do that. So to indent your lines, you're coming up to paragraph and you're clicking this little diagonal arrow here. And then you're coming down to indentation, special, choose first line, and If the publisher hasn't given you the line indent specification, I generally tend to go with 0.7 centimeters. I feel like that looks good to me. But other people have other preferences, 0.5. It's really up to you, but don't indent too far. So once again, under paragraph, diagonal line, under special first line, and then by how much, 0.7 is a fair enough standard. And once you hit enter, that will indent the first line of each new paragraph. Now, again, if you're used to academic writing and something like the APA style guide, then you will indent every first line of every paragraph. But when you're submitting fiction, we tend to do it slightly differently. So in a fiction text or a fiction manuscript, we don't indent the first line of a section. So what that means is you want to shunt the very first line of your manuscript back to the beginning and remove that indent. And then if you've segmented your manuscript, so maybe you've got an asterisk and then you're starting a new scene, again, shunt that very first line back over. And again, the very first line of a new chapter. So if you're starting a new segment, a new scene, then you're shifting that line in again. But for every other paragraph of your manuscript, including dialogue, you're going to have that first line indent. And if you do have different sections to your story, always do put the asterisk in there. Don't just leave it blank because that can lead to some confusion. Although not having the first line indent should make the reader aware that you've started a new segment, just put the asterisk in there to be absolutely certain. Give a visual aid. And if your story does have chapters within it, always give a new chapter a new page using the page break function. Now, if you've double line spaced everything and you're seeing that there's an extra space between paragraphs, then you want to remove that. And again, you're just coming up to the line spacing menu, and at the bottom, you will see that there's the option to add and remove a space before the paragraph or after the paragraph. And you want to make sure that there are no additional spaces either before or after. So if both of these say add a space, then that's fine because that means that there isn't any extra space. But if one of them says remove the space, you want to remove it. So for non-fiction work, we often submit box paragraphs or box text. And this means that there's no line indentation, but there is a space between paragraphs. So it would look something like this. But for fictional work, we have the line indentation and no additional spacing. So if you have indentation and additional line spacing, that's kind of considered to be overkill. So at the beginning of your story, it's a good idea to put your title in bold and centre justify it. All right, so that looks like a really neat professional manuscript. Now, it's a good idea to include a page number and the title of your work on every page of your submission. Again, this is helpful if somebody prints out the work and maybe accidentally drops it, then they can pick it up and they know that all of the pages belong to the same story and which order they're supposed to be in. So you can usually put the page number anywhere that you like, but for a short story submission, it's a good idea to pop it at the top left. And all you have to do is to go to Insert, Page Number, Top of Page, and select the one at the left. And what I like to do is to put the title of my story in italics, just so that people can see that that is the title of the story, it's not actually part of the text. And there we go, that is your manuscript ready for submission. So the last thing to think about is what format you're going to send your work in. Again, check the submissions page, but if they haven't given you guidance, then you tend to have one of two choices. You can either send your work as a document or as a PDF. Now, a lot of authors love PDFs because a PDF is like taking a photograph of your work. People can read it, but they can't easily edit it or copy it. It's not impossible to do that, but it's a little bit more tricky. And so people tend to feel it's a deterrent to people stealing your work. However, I would always recommend the document. And the reason for that is because you can pretty much guarantee that whoever you're submitting to, they're running a competition, they're professionally in the publishing business, they're not about to steal your short story. That isn't what the point of a competition is. And if they really, really, really want to do that, then they can do that with a PDF anyway. So it doesn't really give you that much protection. If you're that worried about submitting to a competition that your work might get plagiarized or copied, then don't submit to that competition. And the reason it's often easier to submit as a doc is because then the judges can change the font size, or they can change the justification, or they can change the line spacing, and they can also use Word's text-to-speech function and listen to the story as they're reading it. So it gives the reader a lot more control over how they want to consume your submission, and anything that encourages somebody to read what you have written is a good idea. So generally speaking, I tend to prefer to send things in docs, but that is up to you. And again, always check the publisher's submission guides first. So I hope that's been helpful, and I'm wishing you a lot of luck in anything that you're submitting to. If you've got any other top tips or any other questions, just drop them in the comments below. And if this has been helpful to you, please consider giving it a like and subscribe.